He's a relentless sort of character, determined, fierce knight who would not give up. So it's hard to talk about the lion without talking about Guilliman. They were very much informing each other. I wanted a relationship between the two, but a contrasting one.
Whereas Guilliman is all that's optimistic about a bright new Imperium with the new Crusades, we wanted the lion to be the dark, secretive side of the Imperium that represents the opposition of Guilliman. And we thought from a narrative perspective, that gives us a really interesting place to go with the miniature as well. We wanted to make sure there was a real clear point between the Horus Heresy miniature and the Warhammer 40,000 miniature. First of all, he has a new suit of armor. It was very clear to us that we wanted him to look like a knight.
Guilliman is a re-embodiment of the Emperor, has a lot of classical and over-the-top decoration. The lion suit was quite stripped back.
He has a lot of personalized elements, such as the lion as an icon. He's got it on his tilting plate. He's also got a sculptural element on his right shoulder pad. And as well as that, he's also got a lion pelt on his back too. So his honorific as the lion is detailed on the model.
A big part of the model is that shield that he's holding. I had this idea that it would be really cool for the loyalist Primarchs to inherit one item from their dad's armory. So we decided that that should be the Emperor's shield.
If you look at the design on the shield, it's a single-headed eagle, which represents the Emperor, with a serpent in his mouth, representing evil, chaos, or Horus himself.
Like the Emperor's suit of armor, it's absolutely over the top. We've seen Cypher, and there's rumours that he's got the lion sword. I think it's just better when there's a bit more mystery about it, so we came up with a new sword.
The way the model's been designed is it could stand alone as a single miniature, and if that was the only thing you ever wanted to build and paint, you've got a really nice model. It's well framed on the base, it's got the watchers alongside it, it's got a scenic element on there. The model itself tells loads of stories about the Dark Angels. You've got four separate head options on there too, which give you loads of choice as a painter. And actually, I think there's a really nice opportunity to bring something that's a mythological part of Warhammer 40,000 to the tabletop.